There's a cosmic visitor in the inner solar system at the moment, and it's far more spectacular than I expected. So I just wanted to make a quick video to show you how to see it for yourself. When I first saw it last week, I was amazed by how bright and easy to spot it was, even just with the naked eye. This is C2020F3, or as it's better known, Comet NEOWISE, and it's an amazing sight in our night skies at the moment, easily visible even if you live in a big city. So it's well worth trying to go outside and get a glimpse of it yourself if you've got clear skies. Comets are small lumps of ice and rock, most of which spend most of their time a very long way from the sun. But they often have very eccentric orbits, both mathematically and literally, which means that occasionally they'll dive into the inner solar system. And when they do so, the intense heat from the sun will cause the comet to start to eject clouds of gas and dust. And that means that these tiny little rocks, which would normally be completely invisible to the naked eye, can develop a large, bright, reflective tail, sometimes bright enough to be seen by us down here on the surface of the Earth. This is a time lapse I made of NEOWISE, and you can see it appearing in the northwest, diving lower through the north around midnight, and then rising higher into the northeastern sky as sunrise approaches. And this is the pattern it'll follow, apart from the fact it's also getting higher and moving west surprisingly fast from night to night as it moves further away from the sun. This is its predicted path as seen from London, but it's pretty similar in much of the northern hemisphere. This first line is the path it took on the 8th of July, one of the first nights it was visible. And this is the path it took on the night of the time lapse. And then here is what it'll look like on the night of Saturday the 18th. So, as you can see, it rises substantially higher and moves further to the west with every passing day. A week later, on the night of Saturday the 25th, it's risen a bit more and moved even further to the west. The easiest way to find it is to look for the bright star Capella, which is near the northern horizon. Find the Big Dipper up and to the left, and then use this chart to work out where in between you can find NEOWISE on the night that you're observing. It looks like a small dot with a smudge above it, and that smudge is the comet's dusty tail. The nights are absolutely glorious at the moment, with Jupiter and Saturn shining away in the south about as bright as it's possible for them to shine. And another thing you're in with a chance of seeing is noctilucent clouds. Clouds that are so high in the atmosphere that they can catch sunlight and reflect it down to Earth even in the dead of night, which means they seem to glow strangely on the northern horizon. This is a picture that I took, and you can see on the right Comet NEOWISE, and on the left a beautiful display of noctilucent clouds. NEOWISE will begin to fade over the next few weeks as it gets further from the sun, cools down, and the chaotic jets of gas and dust on its surface start to calm. And then it's off out into the cold and dark of deep space for a very long time. Astronomers estimate NEOWISE's last dive into the inner solar system was about 4,500 years ago. And these highly eccentric orbits are incredibly sensitive to tiny changes. It's thought that because of the deflections on this particular encounter, NEOWISE won't be back in the inner solar system for another 6,800 years. That means it's going to be gone this time for even longer than it was gone before, and makes it even more worth staying up for. Comet NEOWISE looks great with the naked eye, or even better if you have a pair of binoculars to hand. It should be visible for the next week or two at least as it climbs through the northern sky, getting a bit dimmer as it moves further away from the sun. Comets are beautiful, unpredictable celestial phenomena, so check this one out if you get a chance. Or mark the year 8820 in your calendar for its next visit.